The latest Starship prototype of SpaceX aced a high-altitude test flight on May the 5th, checking all the boxes from takeoff to touchdown for the first time. SpaceX's fans, who were glued to their computer screens during the flight, rejoiced and celebrated the company's success. However, the road to success has been difficult, and SpaceX has tackled many setbacks along the way. Make sure you watch until the end of this video, because today we will talk about how SpaceX made history with the successful landing of the Starship prototype SN15. Subscribe to Futurephile if you haven't already for more such fascinating videos on futuristic tech. Elon Musk's private spaceflight company, SpaceX, was founded on the idea that life should be multi-planetary. Musk has often talked about his ambitious plan to colonize Mars. This is partly motivated by existential threats, such as an asteroid collision big enough to wipe out humanity and perhaps other potential human catastrophes. Settling in other planets would place some of the eggs in other baskets, sparing human civilization if one of them were to experience a cataclysm. But Musk says what is blocking us from doing that is the ridiculously recalcitrant problem of big, reusable, reliable rockets. Unlike most aerospace companies, SpaceX wants to build large reusable rockets, reliable for crewed missions. Somehow we have to reduce the cost of human spaceflight by a factor of 100, Musk added. That's why I started SpaceX. By no means did I think victory was certain. On the contrary, I thought the chances of success were tiny, but that the goal was important enough to try anyway. Realizing this dream requires a vehicle that's up to the task. Starship is a rocket and spacecraft combination that could ferry more than 100 people a time to the Red Planet. In addition, it is reusable, meaning the principal hardware elements aren't dumped in the sea or burned up like some other launch vehicles, but are instead recovered from orbit. They can then be refurbished and flown again, reducing the overall cost of the company. After a series of disastrous test flights, SpaceX's largest rocket Starship soared for the fifth time on May the 5th, hitting an altitude of 10 kilometers, 33,000 feet. It took off at 5:24 p.m. local time from SpaceX's seaside launch pad in Boca Chica, Texas. Like its predecessors, the test ship flew about 10 kilometers and did a brief single engine hover before flipping horizontal for its long coast towards the landing pad. The SN15 then lit back up to flip to vertical position and landed softly and gracefully, using only two of its Raptor engines for the landing burn. This last section was groundbreaking. After attempting similar flights over the past 5 months, SN15's four immediate predecessors all ended up in pieces, in each hitting almost every milestone except soft landing. One of those vehicles, SN10, appeared to land safely at the end of its March flight, but the craft exploded after a fire broke out at its base. Following the landing, a brief fire broke out at the base of SN15. However, it was brought under control after a few minutes. SpaceX chief Elon Musk confirmed the success on Twitter, telling his more than 52 million fans the landing was nominal. Over the last month, SpaceX has attracted a lot of attention on social media. It brings up a point that has been debated in recent years, whether the time and resources spent on Mars colonization could be better spent solving problems here on Earth. Elon Musk's vision was largely regarded as unrealistic. And the most insane part is that a billboard appeared outside of SpaceX's headquarters that read, "Mars sucks," signed by Earth. The billboard was set up by creative Los Angeles agency Activista for Earth Day. While the billboard was designed to raise public awareness about climate change and encourage people to consider what they could do to help, it cannot be denied that it was a spark that lit the fire. Despite all, SpaceX proved the critics wrong with the perfect landing of the SN15. People all over the world congratulated the SpaceX team. One Twitter user said, "Congratulations to Elon, SpaceX, and the Starship team in Boca Chica for an astonishing landing of Starship serial number 15. Amazing work, and I'm thrilled about the direction of this program." Chris Bergin, the managing editor of NASA Spaceflight, says, "We just got a step closer to Mars. It is a straightforward message of congratulations, but it is also a silent response to the critics. SpaceX has come a long way. For each defeat, SpaceX has learned new ways to excel. For example, after a series of failures from SN8 to SN11, SpaceX had long intended to integrate what Musk called major upgrades into SN15. SN15 has vehicle improvements across structures, avionics and software, and the engines that will allow more speed and efficiency throughout production and flight. Specifically, a new enhanced avionics suite, updated propellant architecture in the aft skirt, and a new Raptor engine design and configuration, SpaceX representatives wrote in a description of the SN15 flight. The uncrewed test on May the 5th aligned with the 60th anniversary of the United States' first ever crewed spaceflight, NASA astronaut Alan Shepard's suborbital mission. The historical parallel is coincidental but relevant, as SN15's success represents a significant step forward in SpaceX's plans to help humanity expand its footprint into the final frontier. With the test flight completed, some enthusiasts are already looking forward to the SN16, the next Starship in line. Although SN15 is a full-scale Starship prototype in height and width, it only has three Raptors on board. Future test variants will be more powerful, and we should see these brawnier vehicles fly relatively soon. Musk has stated that SpaceX plans to launch a Starship into Earth orbit before the end of the year. Thus, if the test program progresses well, Starship could be operational in no time. Musk recently said that he expects the system to be fully operating in 2023, though he did admit that his timelines tend to be ambitious. SpaceX already has a Starship mission planned for launch in 2023, which will send Japanese billionaire Yusaku Maezawa and a handful of other people on a week-long flight around Earth's nearest neighbor. NASA has also awarded SpaceX a $3 billion contract to develop a moon landing system for the space agency's Artemis missions. A great deal of work to be completed, but Musk never gives up. Musk seems to be driven by the same spirit that appeared in John F. Kennedy's iconic moon speech. But unfortunately, Musk isn't the kind of person who asks why. Rather, he asks why not. And it is with that same attitude that he's made it this far. So, although he still has miles to go, it does seem feasible. But we should all pause a bit to appreciate how SpaceX has made a history. Like many other times, this time too, SpaceX proved the critics wrong. Their unconventional spaceship with new, never-used-before liquid methane rocket motors, unheard-of aerodynamics, retro-looking fins can indeed do the free-fall flips, gyrations, and land on its feet. Today they showed the world that they can launch a 160-foot tall, 30-foot diameter stainless steel rocket weighing more than 100 tons miles into the sky, and return to land it upright on the landing pad with precision. Dream big, work hard, never give up, and achieve the impossible. This is precisely how SpaceX is setting the pace and making history for all things space. If you like this video, you may also like to watch the video shown in this end screen on SN15 key upgrades. See you there.